Hello.
Oh, hello, Professor Haroche.
Yes.
Hello, this is Adam Smith from Nobelprize.org in Stockholm.
Yes.
We have this tradition of interviewing new laureates for just a very few minutes, so may we speak? Thank you. Congratulations on the award of the Nobel Prize.
Thank you very much.
What were you doing when the call came, when you received the call from Stockholm?
I was walking in the street with my wife, ready to get back home, I was just caught by the call on my cellular phone.
What was your first thought on receiving the call?
My first thought was amazement. You know, I think I had a thought even before I caught the phone, because I saw the code 46 for Sweden. And so I knew the prize was giving today, so I could not believe it, but that was my first reaction. I was really amazed, and of course it's wonderful. And then I learned about it, and it's starting to sink in that it takes some time, because immediately after that I was swamped with phone calls from all over the world, and I'm still trying to recuperate from that, and it's not finished.
No, I think it will go on for some time. But yes, your heartbeat must have increased very, your heart rate must have increased very rapidly when you saw that 4-6.
Yes. I was overwhelmed by this, clearly. And I was also very glad to share it with Dave Wineland when I heard about the news, because it's he's a friend, and I admire his work very much. And we have been in contact with each other for many, many years, and so I'm very glad to share the prize with him.
And in some ways, there's this lovely symmetry about it, that you trap photons and he traps atoms.
Exactly. And I use atoms to study photons, and he uses photons to study atoms. So it's really symmetrical. And at some point during our work, we published papers back to back. Just by chance, it happened that we are doing similar things on his atoms and my photons. There are many similarities between our group and his. He is also working on a very long-range project, as I'm doing in Paris, with a large team of postdoc, visitors, and students. I'm sure he shares my feeling by saying that this prize is as much the prize of all the colleagues who are working with us in our groups than ours. We know the rule of the Nobel Prize. It has to be given to never more than three people, and so it's very difficult to share it. But I want to stress that this is the work of two teams which have been working very hard with a lot of very bright people in both teams.
Again, perfect symmetry, because we spoke to him earlier and he did express exactly the same feeling that it was...
And I did not hear his... My assistant, Theo Belou, told me that you had already interviewed him, but I did not have a chance to hear his interviews.
And it does seem quite amazing to think that in your laboratory you arrange meetings between single photons and single atoms.
Yes, we are doing that kind of experiment. And for a very long time, people were working with huge collections of atoms and photons. And when you work with big ensembles, the quantum properties are, so to speak, veiled. They are hidden because of statistical effects. And if you work with single particles, as we do, then you can reveal the quantum effects in a very dramatic way. And you can learn about these quantum processes, and that's what we are trying to do.
How long did it take to build the apparatus to allow you to do this?
Oh, it took a long time. With the ideas which gave rise to the prize started about, I would say, more than 20 years ago in our lab, and I'm sure it's the same in Dave Wineland's lab. Mm. And it took us many years to build the apparatus and to improve it to the point that we were able to trap the photons for such a long time. So it's a very long-term project, and I'm glad that I was working in an environment which allows for this long-range project to be able to mature and to flourish. I was working at École Normale in Paris, in a lab where we have a very good students from École Normale and from other grandes écoles in France, and a lot of postdocs and visitors from all over Europe and all over the world. And it's a very fantastic atmosphere to be able to develop this. And now I have just changed. I have moved to Collège de France, which is very close to École Normale in Paris, and I have become the administrator of Collège de France, which which is a very important task. And that's why I do not realize very well what's happening, because I will have to manage my administrative task with all tasks which will come from the Nobel Prize, and I have to organize my life. For the time being, I don't know exactly what will happen.
let's hope you have a good assistant administrator also.
Yes, and everybody at École Normale and at Collège de France are very happy and very, very helpful. I hope everything will go well.
It's nice that everyone shares in your joy. Just one last question, because there is so much emphasis on application, but really, yes, the work you do, it focuses on understanding the fundamentals, on understanding this frontier between classical and quantum mechanics.
Yes, exactly. And I cannot, if you ask me what would be the application, I will tell you I don't know. And I will just tell you that I think there will be some application. But whether this application will be for the general public or application which will help to improve some devices which will be used by scientists, it's not clear. To take an example about the work that Dave Wynand is doing, one part of Dave's work is to work on atomic clocks, and he's using this the ability to control single particles to develop clocks which are fantastically accurate. And this precision could be used to develop ways to detect very small effects, like small gravitational shift, for instance. So this is one application. In my work, I am also using atomic clocks in quite different contexts. I use clocks which are so sensitive to light that they can be used to detect single photons. So again, there is some kind of connection between his work and mine. But what would be the use to be able to detect these photons without destroying them, I don't know. I hope that there would be some application, but I cannot tell which.
But the basic research has to come first anyway, yes.
Yes.
Okay. Well, when you come to Stockholm in December to receive your prize, happily we have the chance to interview both you and Dave Wynand together.
Yes, with pleasure. I'm looking forward to that. Yeah.
We are too. So, again, many congratulations and thank you for speaking.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you.